So in this tutorial, we will work on how to build efficient TensorFlow input pipelines for image datasets in deep learning with TensorFlow and Keras. First, we will review the TF data module. Then we will download a sample image file. After gathering all the image file paths in the directories, we will merge the file names and the labels to create the train and test datasets. Using TF data dataset class, we are gonna map, prefetch, hash, and batch the datasets correctly so that the data input pipeline will be efficient in terms of time and performance. We will discuss how map, prefetch, cache, and batch functions affect the performance of the TF dataset input pipeline performance. Moreover, we will see how to use TensorBoard, the add-on TF profiler, for monitoring the performance and the bottleneck of the TF data input pipeline. If you would like to learn more about deep learning with practical coding examples, please subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow my blog on Medium. Do not forget to turn on notifications so that you will be notified when new parts are uploaded. You can access this collab notebook using the link given in the video descriptions. If you are ready, you can get started. So let me see that if anybody is here. Yes, sıradan biri is here. If you have any questions during the tutorial, please write it down to the chat screen. So time to time I will check the chat screen to reply you, and maybe we need to explain more with some examples. So TensorFlow provides us the TF data module, and in that module one of the most important classes is the dataset class. Using this dataset class methods, we can create our own dataset pipeline and we can increase the performance of our models. I would like to talk about this very shortly, but you might ask, what is a data set? Actually, the data set is the form of, as you might know from the machine learning, the X, train Y, and test X and test Y tuples. So we are gonna create these tuples by ourselves. Here, I would like to show very short introduction for it. So how can we create the data sets? Basically, by using the TF data dataset class, we have some methods. The first method is important, that from tensor slices, basically it can create data sets from NumPy arrays, pandas data frames, or the file lists. And after creating your data sets, basically you can actually we use this data set in the train and test, but here you can see that we can go over the data set in a loop and we can get the shape of each element. As we see that it is TensorFlow, so it's tensor, and the shape is integer, 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 as we seen here. The second method is very handy to create the data sets from the text files is TextLine dataset. But basically you provide the name of the files, and then the TensorFlow creates you the line by line dataset for you. I will cover this how to read the text dataset next tutorial, but in this tutorial I will be focusing on image dataset. Another one to use to create the dataset, the method is TF record dataset method. In that method, if you saved your data in TF records format, you can read and create your dataset. The last one we are gonna see here is that list files method. Here you provide some globe pattern, so you provide the path, and in that path what to search for the file, of course. So all the files matching with that pattern will be listed in that method, so you create a data set of file names. Today I will use create my image dataset these list files and the most common one from tensor slices. I will use both of them and explain you. Here we need to talk after reading the preparing the our data set, we need to transform it. Basically, transform means that by using map method, you can apply a function on each of the elements in the data set. I will give some complex example, but here you see that simple one. So we have these numbers in the data set. Basically, we multiply by 2 and return a new data set. So the new data set, as you said, for 2, 4, 6 numbers. So the map is important for us, and I will elaborate the map function in details. You know batch from the train and test module. So when you feed or you evaluate, you use the batches of data. Here the same idea applies. After creating the data set, you can transform the data set into batches. So now they are not one element, as you see here. Now you see that they are elements of 3 batches, here and here. So the batch. Another important function that we are gonna use, cache. So as the name implies, we use the cache the elements in the data set in memory. So it will accelerate how we access the data. Basically, we provide the cache after creating the data set. And after mapping with something, then we can fetch and then cache. And the cardinality, quickly. The cardinality means the number of the elements in the data set, basically. So it's very simple. And more. We have already talked about the map, but I want to give some important information about that. You can write any Python functions, but sometimes these Python functions do not work. Here you see that, for example, you can write such a function here and return some value. So by using this function, you can apply this function onto every element of dataset by using the map here. You see that. So we are just apply the hash function every element of map. So that's the basic usage, but as I explained, sometimes the Python functions do not use. So if you use the Python code inside the function, not on the TensorFlow code, so if you use the Python code, we have two options. We can rely on autograph, convert the Python code into the graph computation. In my example, it didn't work. So the second way is to use Python function decorator. So by using the type TensorFlow Python function decorator, the TensorFlow takes the responsibility of converting this Python function into a TensorFlow function. So I will show you here. Basically, if you see that there is a Python function, so using the Python here in the map, as you might see in the map, we are using 3 commands. One is the lambda function, and we are saying that you are going to use a Python function, and the name of the function is that it will accept this input and it will return this output. So that's the basic usage if you are going to use a Python function. You are going to use always map, and you are going to put the lambda function, and by using this TensorFlow Py function decorator, you can convert any Python function, can be run on the map. So that's the main idea. I want to continue with the prefetch, which is very important for us. When you create a data pipeline, if you use the prefetch, means that you are gonna get the data set elements at the very first run, and then you don't need to call it again and again. So here you see that if you create the pipeline, mostly it should be ending with the prefetch. So basically the first step is mostly batch. After you batch the data set, the caching, and then the last step should be prefetch the each batch data sets. And I will give this example in a moment. But I would like to go over and give the beginning information you are not familiar with DF dataset. Now take. Take is the basic, the simplest one. Basically, it gives you the how many elements you want. For example, 3 elements. It gives you back the first 3 elements from the data set. So you are gonna take 3 samples from the data set. And I think it is like that. Okay, it is so simple. So let me check in the chat screen if we have any questions so far. As far as I see, there is no questions. So if you have any questions, you can just write it down and I try to explain. So let me continue with the code. Before beginning the code, I would like to show here give the dependencies, and we have the tensor board we are gonna use here to record the execution of cell. I will use the auto time. Here is the profile add-on for the tensor board. I am using this to see the how the if data will work my experiments. Here are the references. These are the first 3 are the or for the from TensorFlow. They are important, and for the increasing the performance, you really need and understand these better performance with if data API block. You really understand. Today I will give just a startup. And you can use the this link analyze your data link pipeline. I will go over and experiment with simple ideas, but up to you to go as much as deep you like. Now I would like to show how to do these things. First, I would like to show how to download a data set from the internet website, but first let me show you here. I already download, but let me do again. So by using the wget method, you can download the zip file from the internet, and then you can unzip it here. After unzip it, let's take a look at inside the directory structure. Here you see that we have the images directory and we have 2 CSV file. And on the left side, let me show you here. You see we have the images directory and we have 2 CSV files. These files include the label data. Let me show you. So here we can, using the pandas data frame, we can upload the CSV file to do it. Here you see that we have the file names and the labels. So the labels are in one hot encoded. This dataset is a multi-label dataset, so it's actually not one hot encoded, but multi-hot encoded. Okay. So these are the data, the file names. So these files are in the images directory. I just upload the CSV file to check the name of the file and the, it is label. So I will just here record the labels into a labels list. So I will go and check the label according to the column value, if 0 or 1. Now we are at the moment that we built the, our first image data set by using the TF data pipeline. Here the idea is that first we are gonna go over the images directory. We will collect all the image file path and names. Then we are gonna collect the file names and the labels, and then combine these 2 together into a data set and then train the model. Let's begin now. We can collect these file names in that images directory in 2 ways. The first way is to use from tensor slices method. Here, before doing this, I would like to explain how the PET and the GLOB methods work in PETLIB module. So, by using the PETLIB module, we can specify the PET. Here, we specify the working folder. Then, in that, using this folder, we can GLOB, we can get all the image files, star.jpg, in the images directory into a file name list. Then we can print out the image names and the total number of images in that directory. And we can show the first image. Let me do it. So we are just collecting all the images file names in that images directory. Here we found 2000 images, and then the first image is pet and file name is that, and it is on the screen. So I think everybody understand how we use the PETLIB, pet and the GLOB. So basically GLOB can get the images given the pattern to look for. So here the pattern is that anything ending with JPEG. Now we can create a list of image file pets by just getting the string of that file name. And let me show output. So here we are seeing the first five output, that list. So they are basically the pet and the file name of the images. In most cases, we would like to test the input pipeline with a small portion of the data to ensure the performance and accuracy of the TF data pipeline design. So we don't use all the data set because it takes lots of time. Instead, we are using the small portion of it to test the pipeline correctness and the performance. So I will here do the same thing. And if you look at this code, I will select only 10 of them. So I will use the file names first 10 to create my data set. Here I am using the from tensor slices method by just giving the file names in string. That's all. So by providing these, actually I will create a data set holding 10 file name. So please be careful. I am not uploading or reading an image file. I do not. I just copy, let me say, or create a data set including 10 for the moment, 10 file names. And let me run this. Here you see that in the folder we have 2000 images, you know that. And now we only selected the 10 of them. Okay, so in the file list data set we have only 10 file pet and name. Okay, we have the second method to create the same data set by using the list files. So in that list files, we provide here the file pattern. So the file pattern is the GLOB pattern, as I showed you. So you can give here, for example, you can create a pet first. Using this pet, you can provide the list files a pattern. So in the pattern, we are basically saying that in that directory, find any subdirectory. In that any subdirectory, just copy any images. So you can find this kind of pattern to list files. Then list files will execute these by itself and create your file list data set. I will not use this one because, as the TF dataset documentation mentioned, if your file names have already been GLOB, actually we have done here, remember, we have already done here, already. So, we already done this. Use dataset from tensor slices file names instead. as reglobing every file name with list files may result in poor performance with remote storage system. So I will show this as a second method, but I will use the first method already. So let me continue now. We are at the point to discuss how to prepare the data set, but we first talk about how to use some auxiliary functions. First, what we need is that, let's see some examples in the file list data set. And here you see that actually we are gonna get three samples. You see that we have the three samples here. And we are just getting the file names from the data set and open that file in the image. So here we have the number of data sets in 10. The first three samples. Actually, this thing is stored in the data set, not the image. Okay, and this is the second. And this is the third element in the data set. Okay, so this is the element in the data set, which is just only the path and the file name. So we check the what we have done, and it seems correct. Now, how can we get the label of the given image file name? So remember that we have already opened the CSV file in the data frame. So we have the file name and the label, corresponding label. Now we need to execute such that if somebody gives us the file name, we need to return the one-hot or multi-hot encoded labels. So here is the simple function for that. So if somebody provides the file path, you will get the name of the file here. And using the name of the file should be equal to the file name in the data frame. We get the labels, and we need to convert the labels according to the expected multi-hot. And don't forget, we need to convert this not as a NumPy, but convert to a TensorFlow tensor. Why? Because remember that the TF data works with TensorFlow tensors. So it is important. So let me check how it works. So here I am going to take 5 samples from the file list. So here is just the path and the file name. I provide these onto the screen. Then I will get the get label function to work on with that the file name and get me the label. Here is the file name, you see, and the get label activated and returns me this and this. So you can check that it is working and it's getting the label from the data frame. The second thing that I need for any image uploads, so we would like to resize or scale or do some processing on the image. So we can do this by writing simple function. Now here you see that for resize, I already decided to set some image width and image height. Most of the time the data image data sets have lots of images with various image width and height. Now I am standardized this by using fixed width and height. I also keep these very very low because my idea is right now to show how the TF data pipeline works. So I will try to keep it short, the training time. Here what we are gonna doing is that if you look at here, we are ensuring that we have the colorful images by converting with 3 channels, and then also we have the normalization here, so the image values will be between 0 and 1. Then we resize the image and return to the color function. So that's the process image function does. And the last one that we are gonna use the create our data set, the auxiliary function, is that combine the label and image. So far we have done the necessary functions. Now in that function we are gonna upload image data from the given path. So we are reading the file from the directory hard disk. Then we will process the image, convert to it, scale and resize. And then we are gonna get the one hot encoded for that image. Then we are gonna create our Y-train and X-train and Y-train. So basically we can put these as a tuple to create the train data set. Here is the combined field. So we have the file path as a TF tensor. Don't forget in the TensorFlow data input pipeline, everything should be tensor. Here I am keeping this tensor as well. So what we are going to do, first we are gonna using the TensorFlow library to read the file as a tensor. Then we need to process this image. Then we need to get the labels. Then we can return this as a tuple. So the first part of the tuple is the image data 20 by 20 by 3. And the labels, so one hot encoding, actually it's a one vector with five dimensions. So that's the most important function, putting everything together. Okay, before going on to the preparing our data set, what we are gonna do actually is that we need to decide the split ratio. You know that we can decide train ratio like 80%. Then I am just getting this file list. So in that file list, we have only the name of the files and path of these files. I get the 80% of to the DS train, and then the rest of them is copied to the DS test. So in the train data set, we have the 80% of the file names, and in the dataset test, we have only 20% of the file names from this. So I forgot to run combine. I have to run the process. You just check me. So I shouldn't forget to run all. Alright, so in the train dataset we have 8 samples, in the test 2. So I am keeping very very low of these because we will do several experiments with these and it will still take times, you will see. Now we can ready, we are ready to build the our train and test datasets. In train or test dataset, we have the image data and the label data we have to be. So what we are gonna do at the moment, if you check that in the DS train, we have only some string. So the file path and name. Now I am going to change this into the tuple, image data and label data. What I am going to do is the transformation. So the most important transformation that I am going to use is the map transformation. So what does the map do? Remember that we have seen the map actually applies the map function across the elements of the data set. So I am going to apply the sum function. So create the image and label pairs in the end. As I already mentioned that to use the Python code inside of the function, we have two possibilities: rely on autograph or use the TensorFlow Python function decorator. As I explained that the first method didn't work so far in that example, so I will use the suggested way, the TF Python function decorator. Here you see that I will use the train dataset and apply the transformation. Transformation is the lambda transformation. So I will get the first or the any path, and by using this function, I will provide this x to that function, combine image labels function. The input will be the x, so every element in that DS train, which are, remember that, just the path and the file name. And the output will be some float. So that's the data image. The float 32 means that actually I am going to return 28 by 28 by 3 image as a TF float 32. And TF integer 64 means that I am going to return the labeled at multi-hot code. So in that, you might remember that there is a basic a vector with 5 dimensions. Here is an important thing. Please note that non-parallel calls, and here it means that we need to run this code in parallel, not sequential, to save time. And how many calls should be running at the same time? The TensorFlow provides an auto-tune function for us, so it will decide what would be the optimum for the systems at the moment. So it will provide this. And deterministic false makes it much more easier to calculate. So here we are transforming the file path and names into the image data and the labels. So remember that we already prepared the combine image label function for that reason. Here, let me run this. Okay, so at the end, if you see that it is run and the return value is that, as we expected, the float 32 and integer 64. Okay, continue. As I explained that, we use the non-parallel calls to increase the performance and to create the multiple threads to process the elements. And let me do the same thing for the test data set. Now let me check the train element specs. Here you see that train element specs has two different tensors. The first tensor is just the float 32, and the second tensor is just the integer number. So actually it is the one hot encoding for the label. This is the image data set. Okay, so we have end up with the tensor tuple these and these. Let's observe some examples from that file. So in the train data set we will get one sample here, as you see, and I know that it will return us a tuple. I will get the first tuple into image variable. Next tuple will be the label, and I will put this information. Let me show the information here. What you see here is that when I requested to take one, give me the first sample from DS train. Notice that all the pipeline works here. Look, image file read. Process image activated, image file read, process image activated, get label activated, get label activated, and here is the image shape, combine labels activated, image shape is 32, 32, 3, and the label is, here is the label. So my data set is ready to be used in train and test. But I need to do some prepare some others to convert one hot string labels that I will use in showing you some examples. Here is the show sample. It will read some images and shows on the screen. So now we are gonna see some 9 images, sample images from the data set. Now you notice that they are 32, 32 by 3. And they are one hot encoded or multi hot encoded labels. Here you see. So my dataset is working. Let me check the cardinality of the dataset. So in train we have 8, test we have 2 samples. Anybody has a question so far? Let me check. Anybody question? I see no questions. Let me continue. All right. We We need to decide the batch size. I will use very low batch size. Remember, we have the 8 samples in train. So I will create 2 mini batches by using the batch size 4. Here, I will configure for the performance. Actually, it's a big discussion how to do these things. So I strongly suggest you to read the better performance with the TF Data API. It is the official document. You need to work on it. Here I will just summarize it, but there are lots of details. I would like to put the general strategy here. So what we do in generally that we would like to overlap the input pipeline steps. So reading file paths, uploading and processing image data, filtering label info, converting to image data, all these steps, we would like to overlap these input steps with batch computation during train and test. So remember that we provide the batch, so the model works on the batch, or let me say mini batch. After mini batch 1 finish, it continues with mini batch 2, mini batch 3. So actually we use this idea. During the mini batch, we are trying to do everything in between. Therefore, we would like to save time. Therefore, we are overlapping. But the order of the transformations are really important. In this tutorial, I will show you several examples. But here, I would like to summarize again. So what the prefetching does, prefetching overlaps the pre-processing and model execution of a training step. So if you use the prefetching method or transformer, mostly we use at the end of the data pipeline. I will show in a moment. The caching, another important concept, and the transformation. So we can use this transformer, cache data set. We can either use the in-memory or on a local storage. Actually, it depends on the size of the data set. Now I am dealing with very small or relatively small. It has only 2000 images, relatively small, and it can fit into the main memory. So I can use only caching for main memory. But if the data set you are dealing with is much larger and it cannot fit into the main memory during the training, you can write it to local storage after doing every transformations, I mean pre-processing. And the batching, we already know the batching, so combines the consequences of the data set into batches. So batches important for the training. We are not selecting one batch size, for example, or we are not selecting not usually 256 samples, but it depends on your GPU memory, and of course it depends on the complexity of the problem at hand. But it depends, but anyhow we need to decide what would be the batching size, because we are not uploading the whole samples at once, but we are split the data set into batches, and the model works on batches. Each batch it works on and do a back propagation, then forward, then back propagation, like that. Okay. Now, here I would like to show you a pipeline schedule here. We are begin with the train data set. Okay. We will batch this as the batch size. Now it is 4. Then we will cache the result. After caching the result, we will prefetch these batches while the training happening. Okay. So we will do the same thing for the test dataset, but we are focused on for that tutorial the train, because it's the same for the test. So we are gonna run our model on that, and we will see the effect. Now for the moment, please notice that we are first in the pipeline. We are just get the data set, we apply batches, after we cache, then we will the prefetch. Here for the prefetch means that how many of the elements should be prefetched. Here you can write a specific number, or you can let TensorFlow, decide it by using the autotune function I will let it do. So let me run this. Now we have created our pipeline. That's the whole story about the pipeline. So now let me see the number of batches. Here you see that, remember that we have 8 elements train and the batch size is 4. So we have 2 batches and here we have the 2 samples in the test, so we have only 1 batch. I will use the transfer learning to prepare my convolutional neural network model with ease. Here you see that I let the model know how many classes. We have 5 classes. Okay. Now let me run this compile. Here you notice that I use the dense layer in the end and number of classes here. Okay. And let me compile the model. So in the compile model I use the ADEM. You can use another. No problem. Here we have to use the categorical cross entropy because we are using the one hot encoding for the true labels. And the matrix must be categorical accuracy. Why? Because we have the one hot encoding comparing the dense layer output. I will not use TensorBoard for the moment. I will do some investigation after running the examples. Here is the how we are gonna run the model. Okay. In the model, I'm going to run the first one epoch because I would like to show you what happens. So when I run the first epoch, then I will run the next epoch. So pay attention. Now I am running the first epoch. Remember that we already batch, then we already cache, and we already prefetch. Now what happens? You see that since we are batch, cache, and prefetch, before we run the batches, we done everything before because of prefetch. Okay, and now it takes 5 seconds here or 4 seconds as the TensorFlow reports to execute this. But it was the first epoch because we need to initialize the data pipeline. Now it's initialized first. Let me show you what happens in the next epoch. Please pay attention. In the next epoch, we didn't upload, preprocess, blah 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 in the data pipeline, but we just used the pipeline information from main memory. And it takes only less than 1 second, so it's very small amount of time, less than 0 seconds. Why? So let me show you again our data pipeline. We have the data set, we have batch it, we have cache it, and we have prefetch it. So because of these three transformations, at the first time we run the pipeline, but for the second epoch we didn't need to run it because everything is on the prefetch and cache. To change this, let me do an example for you here. I will batch, but I will not cache, and I will not prefetch. So let me show what happens right now. I will run through all these. Create the model again. Compile and train the model. Okay, now you see that as we have seen the first one, the files are read, reprocess, and run. Okay, again it is 4 seconds, no problem. But this is the first epoch. Now, mostly we run hundreds of epochs. Now, let's check the second epochs, what happens. In the previous example, we didn't need to read again, but here we read everything again and see that 3 seconds for the moment. So if you run 4 epochs, each epoch will read, so execute the pipeline again and again, all the pre-processing, Here, image file read, preprocess image, get label, combine. All of them run again and again for every epochs. So it's a very time consuming. Remember that we have only 10 samples, actually 8 samples. So if we go back here, remember that here we have only batched the data set, but we have not applied cache and prefetch. Now let me change this by caching, but not prefetch, and run after. Let me show the train here. So here you see that we are running the whole again the pipeline, and we have again 4 seconds for the first one. But let me run the next epoch. So in the next epoch, you see that it is finished immediately because we cache it. So caching means that we store all the preprocessed data set in, let me say, main memory. So here for the moment, so we don't need to run the whole pipeline from reading files to the end of it. It saves time. A lot of time. But if we have many batches, actually, you would see that for the many batches, and if the data is big, it will be not enough on the caching, because as I said that sometimes your data set cannot fit into the main memory. In these times, you need to use the prefetch. So assume that your data set, batch data set, there are, let's say, 100 batches. Only 5 of them can fit into the main memory. So after 5 batches, you need to get the, even it's cached into a file, you need to read from the file. Okay, you are not gonna do the preprocessing, but you need to read from the file. So you need to prefetch at this time. In basic considerations, we use in basic. Okay, in basic, we are using this pipeline. We first batch, then cache, then prefetch. Okay. Here, if I let me continue, I'll just provide these observations here for you. So these are the same things that we have already discussed. But I have done prepare for you another thing. Now I selected not 10 but hundreds of samples, and the train size has 80 samples, test size is 20, and batch size is 16. I know these numbers are very very less compared to real information, but it is enough to show you the timing. Now let me show you by using these, any of these data pipeline with these transformations, you see the first epochs and the next epoch times durations. Here you notice that there are almost the same first epoch times, but it changes. Why? If you use the prefetch according to the definition, you can save the time for preparing the batches. So sometimes in the first epoch you get less time, but if you do not use cache, here you don't use the cache, here you don't use the cache, your next epochs will take lots of time because you are running the pipeline from scratch. But if you use the cache in your pipeline, and if your data can fit into the main memory, so your second, your third, I don't know, next epochs will happen in a very, very, very short time. So please, if you apply the data pipeline, TF data pipeline, don't forget to batch, cache, and prefetch. Okay, that's the result. So according to TensorFlow data documentation, the best practice, as I explained, there are several things that I did not explain here. The first one is parallelize the data reading by entirely the transformation. I didn't explain this, but you need to read and understand by yourself. Easy. The other thing is vectorizing the user-defined functions. Vectorizing means that you need to use the vectors to make the calculations. I didn't show it because it is the basic of the or machine learning or the deep learning of with Keras. So you have to do this by yourself. So as a quick recipe, I can say that batch cache prefetch is the 80% correct. So you can use this. Before finishing the tutorial, I would like to talk about the tensor board here. Let me run the tensor board. By the way, anybody has a question? Let me check. I cannot question. All right. Okay. Okay, TensorFlow takes a little bit time to start up. Here we can use the tensor board profile subsection to analyze the data pipeline. Waiting. Okay, tensor board is now alright. Now here we can use the tensor board to by using the profile, you need to use profile. So it will upload our helping functions here. Let's wait for a. Alright, here we have the tools. The tools can use the input pipeline analyzer. This it. Here we have the analyze, but as our example is very small right now, we don't see. But here you see that the data processing in milliseconds takes all the cost. Here you see that encoding data, data processing, which is in our cases takes all the time. Reading data from files, so basically it shows us actually according to these processes which one is the highest amount of time, so you can fix if there is any problem. And here are some links for you to do your to improve your pipeline. I would like to show another tool for you, which is important here, data bottleneck analysis. Now, here are the statistics about the model, and here is the model cache, etc. So you can check your model if there is any problem or not. Since we have used very very small amount of data, we couldn't see. But if you run real data, you need to check this and understand where there is the bottleneck. For example, if the bottleneck in memory, so you need to downsize the batch size, or you need to write down to the file or prefetch more data. Okay, so it is up to your consideration these files. So I almost finished. If you have questions, I would like to answer. If you have no questions, I would like to thank you for your consideration and joining the tutorial. Thank you for your time. See you in a different tutorial. So take care. Bye-bye.